गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट एससी टू सिलेबस, दैट इज फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ दिस सिलेबस इज देयर चैप्टर नंबर 6, दैट इज एल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन। व्हाट आर एल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन? तो इंट्रोडक्शन इज देयर। एन एल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ वेरिएबल एंड कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म्स विच आर कनेक्टेड बाय सम फंडामेंटल ऑपरेशन, दैट इज प्लस माइनस मल्टीप्लीकेशन और डिविजन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल 5x + 8, it is an algebraic expression where 8 is their constant term and 5x is a variable term, but x is their variable and a number multiplied with the variable, that is known as coefficient. Now variable, English alphabet are used in place of a number is called variables. A variable has no fixed value. The small letters of English alphabets are used as variable, that is x, y, z, a, b, c and so on. Next, constants. Constants, these are the terms which have a fixed value. For example, minus 5, 20, 100, minus 10 and so on. Next one is their coefficient. A numerical number multiplied or divided with the variable is called coefficient. For example, 7x, where 7 is the coefficient of x. Next is their terms. The part of an algebraic expression separated by plus sign or minus sign. For example, 2x + 7/-9. Here there are three terms, that is first is their 2x, 7 by and minus 9. In case of negative, we have to indicate its sign also. Next is their types of an algebraic expression. First type is their monomial. An algebraic expression having only one term, that is known as monomial. And second one is their binomial. An algebraic expression having two unlike terms are known as binomial. For example, 5x - 3. The next is their trinomial. Trinomial. In this case, an algebraic expression having three unlike terms. For example, 2x + 5/-10. So there are three terms with variable x and y, and one constant term is there. Next is their polynomial. An algebraic expression having more than three terms, that is known as polynomial. Now in this class we will discuss about the multiplication of these algebraic expressions. The first is their multiplication of monomial. For example, 5x² and 4x. There is no sign of plus and minus. There is a sign of multiplication. So it is a monomial, it is also a monomial. We have to find it their product. We multiply these. So in this case, firstly we will multiply their coefficients, that is 5 × 4, and the term of x² × x and y × y. x² × x, it is equal to x^3, because when the base are same, then powers are added. So 2 + 1, that is equal to 3. So therefore 20, 5 × 4 = 20, x^3 and y^2, because the power of y is there 1 and 1, that is equal to y^2. The similar questions are there of worksheet 1. We have to find the product of these two monomial. So in this case, firstly we multiply the coefficients, that is 9 × 2, and then the terms of x, that is x^3 × x^4. And when the base are same, then powers are added. So 3 + 4, that is equal to 7. So it is equal to 18x^7. Similarly, the second part is there. In this case, two terms are there, two monomials are there. -6a² × 5/7. Firstly, we will multiply the coefficients. दैट इज माइनस सिक्स इंटू फाइव एंड ए स्क्वायर इंटू ए रेस्ट वर सेवन, तो इट इज इक्वल टू माइनस थर्टी ए रेस्ट वर नाइन. सिमिलरली नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज देयर, माइनस एट बाय रेस्ट वर नाइन इंटू माइनस फोर बाय रेस्ट वर थ्री. तो वी मल्टीप्लाई द कोफिशिएंट फर्स्टली एंड देन वेरिएबल्स, वी गेट माइनस माइनस प्लस एट फोर जा थर्टी टू बाय रेस्ट वर ट्वेल्व, दैट इज नाइन प्लस थ्री इज इक्वल टू ट्वेल्व. द नेक्स्ट इज देयर मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ मोनोमियल अगेन. देयर इज क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री, दीज आर सेम पार्ट. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू इज सेम एज इट इज. देयर इज गिवन फर्स्ट टर्म इज देयर सेवन पी क्यू एंड सेकेंड मोनोमियल इज देयर फोर अपॉन थ्री पी स्क्वायर क्यू रेस्ट वर थ्री. तो इन दिस केस फर्स्टली वी मल्टीप्लाई द कोफिशिएंट एंड द वेरिएबल पी विद वेरिएबल पी, द टर्म विद वेरिएबल पी एंड वेरिएबल क्यू. द आंसर वी गेट ट्वेंटी एट अपॉन थ्री पी रेस्ट वर थ्री एंड क्यू रेस्ट वर फोर. सिमिलरली द सेकेंड पार्ट एंड थर्ड पार्ट आर देयर. द नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री इज देयर मल्टीप्लाई द मोनोमियल्स. देयर आर मोर देन टू मोनोमियल्स आर देयर. फर्स्ट इज देयर थ्री एक्स रेस्ट वर सेवन फोर एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस फाइव एक्स रेस्ट वर थ्री. तो इन दिस केस फर्स्टली वी मल्टीप्लाई द कोफिशिएंट थ्री इंटू फोर इंटू माइनस फाइव एंड देन वेरिएबल्स एक्स रेस्ट वर सेवन इंटू एक्स रेस्ट वर टू इंटू एक्स रेस्ट वर थ्री. वेन बेस आर सेम देन पार्ट्स आर एडिड. सेवन प्लस टू दैट इज इक्वल टू नाइन, नाइन प्लस थ्री दैट इज इक्वल टू ट्वेल्व. तो इट बिकम्स एक्स रेस्ट वर ट्वेल्व एंड द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दिस कोफिशिएंट इज इक्वल टू माइनस सिक्सटी, माइनस सिक्सटी. In the same way, we have to do the second part. That is 1.2 into e raised to 2, b raised to 2, 5a, b raised to 4, c raised to 2. 1.1, a raised to 5, b, c raised to 7. So we have to multiply these. Firstly, we will multiply the coefficients and the terms with variable a and the terms then variable b and then the terms with variable c. So we will get 6.6 into a raised to power 8, b raised to power 7 and c raised to power 9. The next part is there, third part, it is also same. Firstly, we have to multiply the coefficients and then the terms of p and terms of q and then terms of r. We will get answer 45 upon 4 p raised to power 3 q raised to power 2 r raised to power 10. Next, the question number 4 is there. Question number 4 is there. Find the product of these monomials and then verify the result using x equal to 1. In this case, this is the left hand side and its product is the right hand side. So we have to verify. We have to place the value of x on left hand side as well as in right hand side. And then we have to check the answer. Is it true or false? So in this case, what we are doing, firstly we will multiply these monomials. Here the coefficients are there 1 upon 2 into minus 10 into 1 upon 5 and the variables are there x raised to power 3 into x raised to power 1 into x raised to power 2 and that is equal to minus 10 upon 10 x raised to power 6. So it is equal to minus 1 into x raised to power 6, that is equal to minus x raised to power 6. So therefore right hand side is equal to minus x raised to power 6. Now we have to place the value of x, that is equal to 1. So in this case, when we place the value, we get answer is there minus 1. In place of x square, we will write there 1 square. Minus 10 into x, that is equal to. In this way we can solve this, so we get minus 1 and the right hand side we have placed the value, that is x equal to 1. So minus x raised to power 6 is equal to minus 1 raised to power 6, that is equal to minus 1 again. So this is related to first worksheet. Question number 5 and question number 6 are same as it is. We have to verify these. we have to verify these. The try these questions myself, that is question number 5 and 6. It is same as question number 4. And then question number 7. Question number 7 is there. We have to find the area of rectangle whose sides are given, means length and breadth are given. In this case, side of rectangles are given, that is length and breadth are there. We have to find the area. And area of rectangle is always equal to length into breadth. The length is there 2a, breadth is there 3a. The area is equal to length into breadth, that is 2a into 3a. It is equal to 12a square. And the units are there square units. Then question number 8. In this case, what is given? We have to find the area of rectangle whose length is given thrice of its breadth. And breadth is also given, that is 4x. So breadth of rectangle is there 4x and length is equal to 3 times of breadth. That is 3 into 4x. It is equal to 12x. Now area. Area of this rectangle becomes 12 4's are 48 into x, that is x square. 48 x square and square units. Similarly, last question is same as it is. In this case, what is given? Breadth is given and length is the square of breadth. So the area becomes equal to b raised to 2 into b. That is b raised to 3 square units. So this is related to first worksheet. Thank you. Have a nice day.